Alright, for those of you who've been maybe looking for a video on how to fletch arrows, this is how I do it. It seems like you waste a pretty good bit of glue, hate to say, but to me it gives the cleanest look that you can find as far as the glue sticking out of the side of the arrows. I know there's plenty of other people that do it different ways really well, but this is just my way. First, I just get the fletch and the clamp here, and I use the Loctite super glue, which I ultra gel in the black case. I like it the best because it's actually like a rubberized formula meant to resist impacts, and it's weatherproof as well. And what I do is I start off, I just run a bead right down the center of it. And like I said, some people say I might use too much. I just try to run a bead down the middle of it. And I like that once you get through squeezing it, the way it's designed, it actually kind of sucks the glue back in, so you don't have to worry about it coming out at the end. Also then just make sure that the jig itself, that the knock is actually rotated in one of the lock positions. You start doing it a lot, it might get out, you might not know. Now what I do up here is I actually hold the arrow. I put a little bit of pressure down this way into the knock, but I also kind of bend it a little bit like this at the same time. And I found what that does, as I put the clamp on, what that does is raise it up so that I get all the air bubbles out of the glue if there are any. Now what I do is I just kind of butt it up here against the back of the jig, and then just kind of slide it down on there. And then as I'm still holding pressure, then I actually just release the arrow, and probably couldn't see it, but just a little bit more glue wind up coming out of it. Now me personally, I just like to let it sit for about 35 to 40 seconds, and it also helps to have like some music or something going in the background, because it does just take a while of just sitting here. Alright, so that's 35 seconds. First thing I do is pull the clamp off. You can see there's little bitty dabs of glue, but you just wipe them. Like I said, the nice thing about that Ultra Control glue, or that Ultra Gel from Loctite, is that it really doesn't stick just by itself to the clamp like some of the other glues I've tried. Now you have your arrow, looks like this right here. I don't know if you can see it, but there's actually a little bit of glue stuck out of both sides. This is where I use a Q-tip. What I'll do is I'll put it on the glue and start dragging it backwards. While as I do, I actually spin the Q-tip to make sure I get all the glue off of it, that excess, and then I just flip it over and I do the other side. Now after I'm done with that, I grab one more Q-tip. Like I said, this uses a lot of Q-tips, but I think it's very clean. And then I just do the back like this, spin it and spin it. And then you can look, and if there's any more that you might have left over, you can just run it one more time over it if you need to, just to clean it up a little bit. Once you get done with that, just move on to the next one. Like I said, place it back in the clamp. Just try to use the same mark to line up your fletchings, whichever one you choose. Me personally, I like it a little further away from my knock. A lot of people will say just put it all the way to as far back as you can where it doesn't touch your face, and that is good advice. But when you're dealing with an arrow, I also work with front of center percentage. Front of center percentage, and if you move that, the more weight right back here, the less your FOC is going to be up here on the front part of the arrow. So I just like to move my fletchings to where they need to be. Kind of keep it closer to the back, but I like to put it to where if you move them a little further forward, you actually get a little more FOC than them all the way back. It's just how it works. You move the weight towards the front of the air shaft. Again, it's on there, clamps in there, flexing the air road, pushing it back and towards the knock, and then I just slide the fletch down on the shaft and then kind of release the arrow while still holding a little bit of pressure, squeeze a little more out, and then just let it sit. And it's a good time to change the song. Now it's been 35 seconds. Wipe off the clamp. Get your Q-tip out. Run it down the side of it while you're spinning it. And see, you can see the excess glue that's been picked up off the side, which is no longer on your arrow. And then I just grab one more. If I can actually get it. And then do the back and the front. Now it's time for the next one. Stick it back in there. Get your next fletch out. And put your bead of glue down the center of it. Push back in flex. I like to rock it from back to front, like I've said. And then just let go of the air. And then let go of the clamp and wait. There's 35 seconds. Pull it off. Like I said, just wipe the clamp off. If you wipe it as soon as you pull it off, you can keep most of that glue off of it. But the nice thing about the Bitzenberg burger is that it's actually metal. So if you start to get some glue accumulating on it, just take your razor knife, scrape it off. It'll work fine. Pull it off. Run your Q-tip. On your Q-tip, like I said, make sure you spin it as you go. You can see how it's collecting the glue. If you just keep spinning it, if you spin it too fast, you'll have to work on the speed. If you spin it too fast, you'll just basically take that glue and put it back down and drag it across the air. And then once you get that, just one spin on the back, one spin on the front, and I have a little leftover right here. Just take it. Kind of roll it off like that right there, and there you go. You got your air fletched up. Hopefully it looks pretty good from the back. Can't tell if I'm how the camera angle's catching it, but fletched pretty well. Look very even, all on there, pretty sturdy. Now this glue right here, you could technically go out and shoot it right away, but me, I always like to let my air sit at least a couple hours, maybe 3-4 hours, and like right now, I'm going to let these sit actually 24 hours, make sure that glue's completely cured before I shoot. Alright, that's the video on how I fletch my arrows. Hope it helps somebody.